Greetings. My name is Chris Lott, and today I'm going to talk about quality learning objectives. I've used the phrase quality objectives rather than effective objectives or best practices because I will be connecting them to Quality Matters, a framework for evaluating and establishing course quality used here at UW-Tacoma. First, we need to establish some clarity about learning objectives versus learning goals. My experience is that many objectives listed in courses are actually goals, which are broad, mostly unmeasurable, higher-order aims. These are useful to have when defining something broadly, as we do with a program or degree, but not as useful for specific classes. Quality learning objectives, on the other hand, will be specific and based on a measurable action. An objective, by virtue of being something done in a course, will naturally be amenable to direct assessment. For example, I recently saw this learning objective in a course: understand the fundamental concepts and elements of data and analytic decision making. This is a fine goal, but being neither specific nor directly measurable, it's not a sound learning objective. A learning objective contributing to this goal might be: create a project charter for an industry client, including the following criteria, and then list the criteria. Often this will be part of a scaffolded series of assignments, some of which might support other objectives in addition to or instead of this one. In this case, perhaps the students would then have an objective to do something like create a decision tree to determine if purchasing company X would be a good choice or not. A helpful way to conceptualize all of this is the SMART model of specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, time-bound objectives. Let's look at each of these criteria individually. First and most important, your learning objectives must be specific. This means not only describing specifically what a student will learn or know, but what they will do to learn and thus know. Having reviewed scores of courses using the Quality Matters rubric, I can safely say that specificity is the most common reason many learning objectives fail to meet a review's expectations. Because quality objectives are always based on a performance, they will always include an action verb. A useful model for ensuring specificity, then, is Bloom's revised taxonomy. Bloom's taxonomy associates actions with broad cognitive domains. A common failing of learning objectives are those that mistake a cognitive domain, such as to understand, or others like explore, know, learn, etc., for action verbs. For example, I've listed here just a few of the actions associated with each domain. A quick web search will reveal many longer lists. If the domain in which your objective resides is, for example, analysis, you would likely want objectives that have your students differentiating, comparing, contrasting, and so on. It might make sense to you to consider the domains first, or it might make sense to you to start with the extensive list of action verbs. Either way is fine. Now, in addition to being specific, a quality objective will also be measurable. This is the second most common problem with learning objectives, but one that is naturally solved by making an objective specific and based on an action. To be measurable, ask yourself if the objective is observable, how you will measure progress and achievement, and how you will ultimately convey that to your students as part of an assignment's instruction or in the form of a rubric. Moving on, your objective should be achievable. Again, this is not describing something that can be done, but something that will be done and directly assessed. Broad cognitive domains like those mentioned earlier, understanding, learning, knowing, exploring, etc., aren't by this definition achievable. Your learning objective should also be relevant. Beyond the obvious notion of relevance, a quality learning objective will be relevant to the alignment of your learning objectives. Alignment is the process of ensuring a cooperative chain in which your unit-level learning objectives all support your course-level objectives, which hopefully support program or degree objectives, and the activities, assignments, and assessments in your course all support specific unit-level objectives. Another way of putting this is, if your unit-level objective doesn't directly support a specific course objective, then it is either irrelevant or one of those needs to be revised. More importantly, if you have your students doing anything in the course that you can't link to a specific learning objective, then one of them likewise needs to be revised. Finally, a quality learning objective is time-bound or timely. In other words, it is one that is both in a fitting spot in the sequence of the curriculum in your course, but also one that has clearly defined time limits and deadlines. Developing explicit, smart, aligned learning objectives isn't easy, particularly if you are, like myself, after more than 20 years as a teacher, someone who leans toward the intuitive approach to the art and craft of teaching. But there is a good reason Quality Matters has such learning objectives at the heart of their rubric. Having quality objectives smooths the sometimes rough waters of class development and design, charts the course for assessment activities and assignments, and clarifies the journey and the destination for the most important travelers, your students. For more on learning objectives, check the Office of Digital Learning site for toolkits, documentation, and other videos in this ongoing series. I also welcome your questions and feedback to clott@uw.edu.